Well, paleontologists, they saw that. They saw all these animals, but the fact is, if you're thinking about it, if you think about Darwin's tree of life and so on, he was saying you got simple molecules and all of a sudden you've got a gradual evolution going up, and then he had the tree where all the branches went. But you had the precursors in front. These guys all showed up, an explosion. That's why you call it the Cambrian explosion. What was the problem that all of a sudden the paleontologists realized? Or another way of saying it, what's the deeper problem that is apparent when they found this?
In my book, I talk about two mysteries, the mystery of the missing fossils, and we've talked about that a bit already, but there's a deeper problem that the Cambrian explosion and other similar explosions in the history of life raise, and that problem is, how do you build all this new form? It's an engineering problem, in a sense. How does the Darwinian process of natural selection acting on random mutations generate that amount of new form in the time windows that are allowed by the fossil record? And that, in turn, reflects another mystery that we've already talked about, which is the mystery of the origin of information. If you want to build life in the first place, as we've talked about before, you have to have DNA to build the proteins to service the cell. But when you have new animal life arising, what emerges with a new form of animal life are new anatomical systems, new organs and tissues. And those new organs and tissues require new cell types. And each new cell type, for example, if you have a digestive tract, if you have a gut, you need digestive enzymes to service the cells that make up the gut. So where did those enzymes come from? Those are proteins. Well, they would need information to build them in DNA. So when you have a new explosion of biological form, it in turn requires an explosion of biological information. And the question is, can the mutation natural selection mechanism build the amount of information that's needed to account for the explosive origin of animal life in the Cambrian period and other similar explosions, or is it insufficient? And that's the question that I think is now very much at the forefront of many biologists' minds, including many people working in evolutionary biology.